Bell Cut.
Hey, what's up, guys? Herbie here, and welcome back to Shovel Knight. Hey, in the last episode, we took on Treasure Knight's level, and we also beat some of the Wandering Travelers. And this episode, we're going to Plague Knight's level, and also hopefully maybe Mole Knight's level. So, Plague Knight's level has quite a number of things to watch out for. First, you got these little fire platforms. You also have those exploding rats, which died quite easily to my shockwave move. And I can't reach that chest. Hang on. Wait, maybe if I can. Hang on, I have an idea. No. Dang it. Just out of reach. Nah. I can't reach the chest. Fish down here. And it's the goldfish. Quite literally. It's made of gold. Alright. First checkpoint. Okay, yeah, that doesn't break through walls. A lot of exploding rats in this level. But thankfully we can heal up. We hop down here. We also have these little wizard guys like for potions. There's also these very fragile blocks that break instantly when you put the shovel on them. And once again, another gimmick. Yeah, because these pots that certain timing to them. And also those annoying fairy enemies also exist too. And I made a mistake. I was trying to go for a jump from the front, but I realized that was going to lead to a death, so I tried moving back, and then I ended up dying because of it. Yeah, but moving on. Move past then. Go. Alright, can't pass that. Maybe just move on. There's a spider that shoots potions, get rid of him real quick. And I did not mean to drop down there, but hello, what can I do about it? More exploding rats, don't want to break the checkpoint. Oh, bird potions, slimes make a return. That nearly led me to my death. can't quite get the sheet, you know, the music sheet, but I know that there is a way to get it. You gotta think there's like a little space, like, you go, it's like, if you try and, somehow get up to that wall, there's like an invisible, like, little platform hidden. You can go up there, you go down, you can go grab the music sheet, that's how you do that. But, I didn't do that. But then again, this isn't like a 100% completion thing. This is just, a playthrough of Shovel of Hope. And then there's this guy, he's a pretty cool mini-boss. He's like the only mini-boss I actually fight. He's getting progressively faster the more you hit him. Either that, that's just a thing that happens. So just get him here. I actually should drink my chalice here. So that way I don't die at the last second. And now we have these fiery platforms. They're now timers. So you no longer have. So it's no longer a matter if you step on them. It's a whole deal of like them. They activate automatic. They operate. And we also got the Ikora Boldness, which becomes invincible for 10 seconds. Great for those tough spots. That'll be very cool, especially useful for like boss fights and all that. Might use that in Plague Knight's fight, maybe. I don't know if I remember to do that. And once again, these knights, the knight enemies return. Do not like them. And it's the reason I die. And he's just jumping on the spot to symbolize that he beat me. But it's only a setback. A minor setback. I'll get him next time. I'll get him good. The accuracy seems to work good. Make a poker jump as well. Oh, that is clever. Plague Knight, you are a clever little one, aren't you? There we go. Quick efficient. So, and it's lost forever. Thanks a lot, game. Thanks a lot. Okay, this is gonna require the face locket. Come on. You gotta be fast for that. You gotta be fast. You gotta think on your toes. You know how it be. And not even that could save me from death. This game sure loves killing me and stripping me of my money. But it's a good thing we have the final guard armor, which means I only lose half of the money. I only drop half of my, gold when I die. And end up in and die in the same spot, practically. This is my problem with the game. It's my problem. I feel like it's gonna be difficult at times, but I feel like I should also stop whining like a baby. And just, move on with it. And I never had this much trouble with my other runs. This guy's a boss fight in of itself. We're only like halfway through the stage. Just die already, please. And they're gone forever again. Why does this keep happening to me? I do not understand. What? I thought I had way more health. I'd just die there. I swear I had so much more health than that. This game sometimes. Oh, that nearly cost me death. I nearly killed myself there. I'm having way too many near-death experiences in this game right now. I'm just gonna look at you. Please, I don't wanna deal with you. I don't like you. Me no like you. Please leave me alone. Thank you. And I screw myself over. And the worst part is I can't get this money back. Can't get this money back. And what about the fishing rod? Here, why is it that when I went through this in a casual playthrough to, you know, figure out what I need to do, I was doing so well, that the moment I try to do this on a let's play, I'm sucking so badly. I don't get it. It sucks. Stupid, I don't get it. No way I can even reach that. Close. This game needs to stop with the heart attack, man. I can't take it. Alright. Now we have these Shovel Knight slots. Slime clones. And I still can't remember, and I know that there was a point in this level where we would find, like, one of those, like, you know, little weapons items Chester gives us, like the relics. I don't know where that is. Is in this level? I don't know. How did that hit me? I thought I got him. I got him first. I'm pretty sure there's like a kind of secret up here. Yeah, there is a secret up there, but I didn't reach it. These guys can also do a bunch of things Shovel Knight can do. And if that wasn't enough, the spider guy's back. Again, me not like you. What? Golden fish. Let's go on here. And the entrance is the last checkpoint. And we just got a little drop down here. Yeah, and this is where we will meet Plague Knight.
Hey, leave me alone.
Show yourself, Plague Knight. Your trickery will not stop me.
Trickery? The fruits of my research are no mere trick. Boom! Now, let's have a lesson, shall we? I promise. It will be enlightening.
So this is female Plague Knight we're battling, and the only difference being with her, compared to her and regular Plague Knight is hat. She has a hat, and that's about it. Hang on, I need to get this real quick. There we go. Whew. Save myself there. we go. Feat accomplished. Halfway. That's 4 out of the 8 Order and a Quarter members we've beaten. Oh boy, was Plague Knight's level quite tricky. And so before we go into Mole Knight stage, there was a little sub that I wanted to let you guys know. During the last between recording of the last episode, I made some modifications to the body swap. Yeah, and I made it so that Mole Knight is female and basically switched Tinker Knight from female to male and switched Mole Knight from male to female. It's mostly because I kind of haven't been thinking about it. I kind of like Mole Knight as a female better than I do as a male. I mean, that's just personal preference. But anyways, we're heading to the Lost City Lair of Mole Knight, which is probably my favorite level in the entire game. So, let's get digging. Here, some old goodies, some of the bell cliff, go fishing, and it's a trample fish, or just a trample. Alright, bye pal. And yeah, we never got around to, we never used that Beaker of Boldness on a Plague Knight, but oh well. So we got these little lava, little dropping things. There's also these, alright, both show people, and I died. Right at the beginning. Because I was trying to explain things to you guys. I should really stop talking and just focus on the game, shouldn't I? Yeah, but that again, that would be boring. I like doing commentary. Yeah, I want you guys to see my reaction. It also introduces these obsidian blocks. There was also a crack in the wall there. I need to try and see what that's about, because I don't know what it is about. But I have a rough feeling I know what it is. And also, by the way, you know that the relic that I missed in a Plague Knight stage? Well, I this thing called the Alchemy Coin, and It says here, toss a coin for a chance at riches. I don't really know how it works. I guess I'm just horrible with luck. But there was a crack, and there was like a small crack in the wall that, like, just before that beetle. And also, by the way, if you miss a relic that you, if you like miss a relic in like a level, you can go to the village, find Chester, and give it to you. And I die again! It's a lot of effort just to see if I can figure out what that one crack of the wall is. I don't know if I can even figure out what it is. I feel like I know what it is. I don't know. Maybe I'm going crazy. Maybe I'm just being crazy over absolutely nothing. Maybe it's just an ordinary crack. Probably what it is. So what say we forget about that? Just progress with the level. We also have this big beetle with these little jelly pad things bouncing. We gotta dig ourselves a path. Path cleared. There's a little chest here. We can Fine. Little beetle stops for us here, so that way we can go up here, continue on, and there's this guy here, which I'm just gonna use the phase lock hit on. Just gonna walk past him because I don't feel like dealing with him, and here is our checkpoint. And also, there's another gimmick, there's these little moles. Like, from here on out, there's gonna be like some moles that are like hiding in dirt piles. There's little sticking spots. Yeah, there's gonna be some of them hiding in there. They pop up once or twice in this game. And so, yeah. Another one of you guys. Do you guys ever give up? I'm guessing by your constant persistence, no. But he did die. So that's that. Anyways, moving on. This is another gimmick in the level. He's a breakable block. This guy survived. You were not supposed to do that. You can go up here. Ooh. Special area. We gotta like shovel jump off these lava fish. And I die! There's a chest there. But I wanna get that chest so I can get the money. And so I can get my gold back. Nothing about my gold. And how did that hit me? Oh well, it doesn't matter, the guy's dead now. Sound like a murderer to say that. Alright, we'll wait. Now. Yo. Probably should have killed him. Music sheet there. Don't think I'll be able to get that. Oh well. And I die! Again. But I mean, at least I managed to get my. But at least I got the chest and the music sheet. So that's that. Does that come up in another part here? Get that. Here. And this is where, that little crack in the back at the beginning where I thought that was where the dust knuckles, but then I, remembering that this is where I get the dust knuckles. And these are one of the coolest items in the game. You can punch through dirt blocks, like this. It's the coolest thing ever, and we got an achievement, knuckle down. Love it! I was pogo jumping on them. I guess I can't pogo jump on fire slimes. Okay then. Be like that game. Another mole. Trying to kill me. Just an ordinary Wednesday. When a mole pops out the ground, you'd be like, I'm gonna kill you. I'm kidding, that never happens on a Wednesday. I don't know what kind of Wednesday you're having. So here's another gimmick. In the level, we have Jelly Ground, a little bouncy bounce. I like it, really nice, pretty cute. And also with these little slime blobs. Here, they're important. I can bounce on them. They all can also turn fire slimes into regular slime. You can move them across. stuff like that. And then we can do some puzzle solving with this, and we can actually turn the lava into jelly, which is pretty neat. Yeah, we do that. There we go, thank you for turning it into lava. We can go here. Goodbye, good riddance. But here we could do some more Dust Knuckle challenge. This guy can start moving. There. Now, we're already getting this level done way quicker than what we did with Mole Knight. Tussle through here. And here's Mole Knight with her flaming ponytail. Yeah, you're out of your depth, Spelunker. Are you lost? These ruins belong to the Aegis, Mole Knight. They're mine now. But more importantly, is that your digging implement? I'm astonished you made it 10 feet down with that rusty trinket. I will bear it. Alright. Alright. So it's Mole Knight. She can be a bit tough business. Yeah, find which hole she's hiding in. That happens to be the one she was in. Kind of trapped in a corner here, but nothing to worry about. I can make it out. And we nailed it! And then the mole's coming to take her away. Alright, bye guys. See you around. Yeah. And there we go. We have now currently beaten 5 out of the 8 Order of No Quarter members. And I'd say we're about roughly halfway through the game, I'd say. And now we got another dream sequence here with Shield Knight. We gotta rescue her again. A lot of money out of
the dream. Wake up. You got this. Open this chest here. And it is a meal ticket, which can help us get more health back at the village. That opens that little spot. And the cloud flow. And we have the last three Order and a Quarter members take on. But we'll be dealing with them in the next episode. But for now, let's return to the village and, you know, do everything we need to do. Like handing the music sheets to the bard. Head up here. Talk to Gastronomer. Give him the meal ticket. Yep, ready. Get that. That's at 9 health. And I believe, there's no more meal tickets in Goatician. But there is still one more meal ticket we could achieve by beating the last few Order and a Quarter members. So I'm actually thinking maybe we could spend a little bit of money increasing our magic. I think that'll be it for today's episode, guys. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like down below, comment, subscribe. Click the notification bell so you don't miss an upload made by me. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.